I'm Callie, and this is Texan TV. Team, please see Mr. Robertson in room T1B. There will also be a meeting Wednesday, October 18th for people wanting to join the team in room T1B. Impressionist school portraits will be on campus from 7:45 to 2, Monday, October 16th in the auditorium foyer to retake photos for teachers, seniors, and underclassmen. Teachers, we are scheduled to take the fall senior panoramic picture on Monday. We will release students from their fourth period class at 2:15 to take the picture. Students should take all their belongings with them at 2:15. Seniors will be dismissed after we take the picture.
My name is Leah Warren, and I'm co-captain of the A-team freshman volleyball team. I tend to have a bad attitude too, but like cheering and letting my teammates know it's okay to make a mistake and like we can shake it off and come back from it is how we keep it up. My favorite thing is serving because I have little arms, but I have a really hard serve, and I like to like intimidate the other team with my serves. My goal is to go to college for it, to get a scholarship. I don't plan to do it for a living, but it's something that I do want to do. Nobody is perfect. Yeah, our captain isn't perfect. I'm not perfect. We all make mistakes, and it's okay because volleyball is a game of mistake, and there's gonna be trials and error. But we can get through it. It encourages me when people like come to me for help. Like people will be like, Aaliyah, how do you serve like this, like that? That keeps me going because I don't think I'm that good. Because if I was, I'd be captain. But it just, when people recognize how hard I work, that keeps me going. I love Coach Henley. She's very understanding, and there's times when she's very hard on us because like she wants to see us do good, and that's one thing I really love about her. She's straightforward about it. Like she tells us what we do wrong and how we can fix it, and like she's not just one of those coaches that make us run. Like she demonstrates. She's very hands-on with us, and I really like that.
There will be a kickoff meeting for the Art of the Covenant Bible Club on Wednesday, October 18th in the Little Theater from 2:50 to 3:50. There will be an obstacle course, food, fun, and fellowship. Everyone is welcome! Do you like competition? Is math your thing? Then maybe one of the UIL math events is what you're looking for. Whatever your passion is, calculator, number sense, or mathematics, see Ms. Self in room 619 and she will direct you to the right place. Tournaments start next month, so check it out soon.
It's a new program where students must have a bus ID. It's going to be yellow, but it basically has their student information, their ID, their address, and also what bus they're supposed to ride. Well, this is a district-wide initiative. This is part of the bond program that we had, that the voters voted for. And it's really to make sure that our students are safe and secure, even when they're en route to school. It is a Zonar, so we do know that when kids are on the bus, when they scan in and when they scan off, we'll keep track of them better. It was thought that, again, especially for our younger students, that we know exactly where they are at all times, but also for our older students. I think there's a lot of times where parents have a lot of questions. They may not have access to technology, and they can't find out where their students are. Mm-hmm. And this is just a way to reassure the parents that they that their students are safe. You will have to have that pass. We are not ready to implement an ID for the students that go from the CTC to their homeschool, mm-hmm. but eventually that will also occur.
They do.
As a matter of fact, I have a copy of that roster now. Every bus driver should know exactly who's supposed to get on their bus and what stop they're supposed to get off. So that's going to be their responsibility as well. No, we don't have that policy in place. Not here at school. Teachers can still issue a yellow temporary ID, and they can keep track of that, and you know, consequences can be given based on, you know, what a teacher wants to do and also what an assistant principal wants to do. But students must have proper identification to get in the building. That's just the regular ID that everyone has. But what's going to be more important about this, the transportation ID, mm-hmm. is that the bus drivers will not allow students on a bus. So technically what can happen is that they could be left. And I know there'll be some students that are not very good about keeping up with their ID, but in order to get on that bus, they have to have it. Now, we allow students to come into the building without an ID, and then we issue a temporary one. And there'll be a process for issuing a temporary bus ID, and they can also buy a new one if they lose one. But it's going to be a process that we go through. So the lesson here is that keep up with your ID. Keep it in a safe place, much like your phone or anything that's very important to you. Make sure you hold on to that ID. This policy has gone into effect for the last couple of years. They started off with elementary schools, and then they went to the junior highs. So many of the junior highs already have this policy in place. Many of the elementary schools already have this policy in place. So the high schools are just now getting on board. So this is, I think, year two, and all the high schools are getting the same presentations. Yeah.
Destination Success / Parent University is happening right here at Sam Houston High School on Saturday, October 28th. It's a free half-day college prep event open to all AISD high school students and their parents. The event will include college prep presentations, FAFSA, TASFA, workshops, SAT, ACT prep presentations, free food, prize drawings, and more. It will be presented in English and Spanish. Go online to www.aisd.net/parent2 to see the complete list of presentations and activities, as well as to register for the event.
I got really emotional and I couldn't hold myself.
You couldn't hold yourself?
Anyways, in South Africa, you cannot take a picture of a man with a wooden leg. Why not?
You can't take a picture of a man with a wooden leg. Why not?
Yeah.
Because he's going to Photoshop.
He's going to Photoshop?
Yeah.
So y'all don't know? Y'all want me to tell you the answer?
Yeah.
Where's the answer? Anyways, you cannot take a picture of a man with a wooden leg. You need a camera.
You need a camera?
You can't take a picture with a wooden leg. You need a camera.
Oh!
Bring me my rights right now. I'll answer the question.
You got the rights to remain silent and answer these questions. I'm here with who?
Victor Hutto.
Victor Hutto. And as you could tell, he's Sam Houston law enforcement, right?
Yes, sir.
A woman shoots her husband. She then puts him underwater for 5 minutes. Finally, she hangs him. 5 minutes later, they both go and enjoy a nice dinner. How is this possible?
That's called a dysfunctional relationship.
Jacob, in South Africa, you understand?
Yeah.
Place where you're not welcomed. Why can't you take a picture of a man with a wooden leg?
Because I'm not welcome there.
So I'm here with
Crystal in Georgia.
Georgia. Like Georgia. Like the town or the state. Yeah, the state. Is it illegal for a man living in North Carolina to be buried in South Carolina?
Isn't it the same place? North and
what class is this? This is AP history? You see how disappointed your teacher is back there? Look at him.
No, it's not illegal because you can't
get a close up with the teacher. Look at how disappointed he is.
Before we begin, what's your password?
Password?
Yeah. Some months have 30 days while others have 31 days. Which month has 28 days?
February?
That's wrong.
All of them do, but yeah, February has exactly 28 days. But they all have 28.
Oh! Let's get him, Mr. Gilmore!
Okay, hold on. Before anything, I think you should give Georgia zero for messing that up.
What? I mean, that's not hard. That's hard to
create.
Oh!
Oh,
no!
The teacher throwing his jacks!
Oh! He just ended your career!
Look, she has a banana ready.
Yearbooks are now $45 for the rest of the school year. We take payments in room 511 or pay in full online at texanstalk.org. We do not order extra yearbooks. We do interview students that order early. We will publish student interviews in the yearbook. Interested in becoming a wrestler? Come after school from 3:15 to 5, Monday through Thursday, in the MAC. You need a physical in order to participate. Season starts November 13th. Lit Crit, we will meet every Wednesday after school in room 413 from 3 to 4. Sam Houston's Project SOAR is now taking applications. Project SOAR is a mentoring program on campus that works with everything and everyone. They achieve academic results through a mentoring program to help our ninth grade Texans. Pick up an application in room 1305 with Mrs. Sanchez or with Mr. Gray in the agriculture temporary between Gym A and Gym B. Your senior quotes. Visit TexansTalk.org and tap the senior quote button to turn in your yearbook quotes. The link closes October 31st. Seniors, 2018 Texan tributes are on sale now. Prices are reasonable, but space is limited. 1/8 of a page is 35, 1/4 of a page, 45, 1/2 of a page, 55, and a full page is $65. I'm Callie, and this has been Texan TV.
This is Coach Hanley!
10th period U.S. history class, and thanks for watching
TexanTV!